All right, Peter, I'm here in the Texas delegation with George W. Bush, Jr. Now, Mr. Bush, you are 42 years of age.
That's right.
Well, how does it feel to have your dad select a man to run with him who's 41?
Makes me feel old. But I am excited about the choice. I think Dan Quayle is going to be a good compliment to George Bush. Not only will he help in Texas, he's going to help all over the country. We're winning team, Sam. Winning team.
Now, Peter Jennings wants to know how many Bushes are there. I want you to count them all up. I want the nieces. I want the nephews. I want the first and second cousins. How many are there?
All of them?
Yeah.
Over 50 plus. Five of us on the floor as delegates in the immediate family. A couple of brothers and sisters for my dad. We love our dad. That's why we're out here in the trenches, Sam.
Well, now, Mr. Bush, I have heard it said that you call your father Big Boy. Is that correct?
I call him Sir. I call him Big Boy. I call him Mr. Vice President. But most of the time, I just call him plain Dad.
What sort of relationship do you have with him?
Very close, like all of us.
Okay, close. But, I mean, do you
talk to him all the time,
Sam?
Tell
jokes to each other?
Absolutely. Throw horseshoes with him. He's a pretty good horseshoer. Occasionally flops it too much. But we love him. Tennis.
Okay, very quickly, we asked Marvin Bush what we should know about his father that we don't know. What do you think we should know? And we're going to compare notes now.
I would say that George Bush is the most thoughtful politician ever. He cares about people. That's why he's written so many handwritten notes.
Is there anything wrong with him? Come on now.
No. The only thing wrong with him, Sam, is he won't brag about himself enough.
Okay. Thank you very much, George W. Bush, Jr., a chip off the old block. Now, Rhett Hume. Rhett?